Paul and Paul.
Two Pauls, one's cooking, one is not. Paul from Paul's Paella has already got the special concoction going. Yeah. Matt, what's going on right here?
Well, I like to make sure my saffron is well pulverized, so I mix it with various spices and just kind of beat it up, and then I'll add it to my stock.
Are you making paella, or are you going to torture people? I mean, how do you get on an airplane with any of this?
Well, I don't. When I do this at home in my house, I have 100 pounds of beef on a spit. That's my barbecue equipment, actually.
Dude, where do you buy stuff like this?
There's a great American company called Zombie Tools. They look interesting. Extremely functional, very high quality.
So you're going to use this before the day's over?
Well, if
you that for show?
Give me a whole pig back here, and it's
then you would use it.
Then I get my fork and you carve away, it'll be good.
I got it. All right, so we're getting just quickly take us through your workspace.
Okay.
Obviously, everything's going to end up over here before the day's over,
you
right?
You bet. A lot of this is stuff I picked up when I was in the military, mostly in Turkey. 200-year-old antiques, Ottoman. Which, by the way, all fits very well with paella because it is Moorish Christian Roman fusion food, okay? So, this is a lot of aesthetics here, but it's also my stock and my spices and everything else.
All right, but the reason why we wanted to have you in, because back in the day, we were showing a story with Running with the Bulls. You ran with the Bulls. We have some video, not of you per se, but of what's going on. Tell us about your experience.
Yeah, well, you notice the back of my scar says 1591. That is the first Running in the Bulls in Pamplona, Spain.
Yeah.
And it's a fiesta of San Fermin. It's a part of a celebration.
And when did you do this?
I did it in 1994, which is when I was first introduced to paella in Pamplona. I lived out this stuff for a week when I was there and just loved it.
And your mom saw you on ESPN?
Yeah.
I mean, do you always get close to the Bulls, or can you do it safely?
Well, not always, but I did, which is why I was a Air Force major at the time. I was running with another young officer, and he fell down, and a bull started verging on him, and I didn't see the bulls. I started shouting at him to get up. You know, and I didn't know there was a bull right behind us, so all the TV cameras were woof, and Maltese mom, well, I keep stuff like that a secret, if I'm major or not, saw me on TV, and I got in a little bit of trouble.
Holy moly. So, and did you do it every day or just one time, or?
I ran the actual running in the streets and made it to the stadium. I did that once. The rest of the week, I was exploring the benefits of sangria. So, and I'm real good at that.
All right, well, that's our our Running with the Bulls conversation. Yep. The rest of this is going to be about paella. Yep. We'll talk about that as the day progresses. So by the end, we're going to have a beautiful piece of art that we can eat, right?
A one-of-a-kind design. Never be repeated.
Right. Paul from Paul's Paella will be with us all morning long. He is making up his special mixture.
So fun and passionate about his paella. Would you look at that?
It's already got some of the main ingredients.
And I know, I didn't realize the process that he put the saffron through, that was really the secret ingredient.
He was grinding his saffron.
Yeah, so he really, does he mix anything else in with the saffron?
Yes, there were all sorts of special ingredients in that little brown box over there.
13 spices that
you can't
talk about?
Yes, I watched
it.
Okay. But I got so intimidated by the torture tools.
Torture tools?
Look at the size of that knife.
Paul, that's a spatula?
No, over by the truck. Look on the table.
Those do look like torture tools a little bit, right?
Like, I'll talk. I'll tell you anything
that
you need to know.
That is a knife. Holy cow. Yeah. That's when Crocodile Dundee goes, that's not a knife.
Yeah, this is a knife. Exactly.
Look at that.
Holy moly. Okay,
what is he using those?
Those are from Spain.
Yes. He tried to put that in your waistband, though.
Get through
customs?
Yeah.
Not going to happen.
What is he chopping up with?
He says when he has a big hunk of meat, that's what those are for.
And this is a meat paella. It's not a seafood paella.
No. Hang on, Paul. Bob, I want to capture this for social media purposes. The wine is about to go on.
Yeah. Ready?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
And is this all flavoring?
Wine adds, I got the mushrooms and the Irish butter with some heirloom vegetables. That wine adds a little kick. Tomorrow I'm doing a halal paella that will not have wine.
Okay, fair enough. So where are we in this stage of the game?
We're getting all the juices out of the meat proteins, add some Irish butter to that too. And I'll push all of this aside, and then I add my onion, garlic, tomatoes, and anchovies.
So I see sausage, I see bacon, I see chicken, I see beef. I see carrots. I see
mushrooms.
Yeah. What am I missing?
You got there's two sausages there actually. You got it all. That's halal beef and it's halal chicken, marinated pork.
Now,
it,
is this have to be the finest of the finest for all your paellas, or can
This is my favorite for flavor, chicken and pork. I put as much meat protein as I can. So if you want me to add some seafood, I will, but that means a little bit less of this.
Got it. So how many different versions of this do you have in your head?
Infinite, because I customized each paella. I talked to the customer, they might not like cashews, they might not like coconut cream.
Did I see cashews in here?
That's going in later. Okay. I got, there's still more going into this.
All right, so for people who want to do this for a party or whatnot, this is what you're about, right?
Pretty much, a customized.
How do they find you?
Huh?
How do they find you?
Paul's Paellas on www.paulspaellas, Instagram, Paul's Paellas. And there's contact information on both of those. Got TikTok also.
All right. Mm-hmm. So he's a social media star as well. Mm-hmm. We'll have more paella coverage for you right after these commercial words.
Perfect.
Here on the patio talking with Paul of Paul's Paella. And we're saying this is the first Friday you've been here.
I believe it is.
I think ever.
Yeah.
You usually come on the weekends. So this is
Sundays,
great. We get to have you here. So we're looking, we've always talked about how beautiful your paellas are. And this is how the process unfolds. So tell us what you're using.
These, I have some custom made pieces, but these are all cake rings and cookie cutters.
Fantastic.
Today, I've had some I've had tailor made, you know, but you know, in Spain they might put like some lemons around the outside or a crab or a lobster in the center. They do a little decorating.
Yeah,
I decorate the whole surface. That's what makes me different.
You make it a masterpiece.
Thank you.
So, is there a specific name for this type of paella when you're using all the different meats? I mean, because there's seafood paella.
Yeah. Oh, well, this one was not really. The closest thing in Spain that has a name would be a Valenciana, but it has rabbit and snails in it.
Well, thank you for not adding the rabbit and snails morning.
Someone says they're having an authentic paella. Chances are, no, they're not.
But
I call it the chicken and pork.
Chicken and pork. Okay, because I see sausage.
There is sausage
and
in there.
Bacon.
There's halal chicken balls. I got beef in this one also. I have a halal wedding tomorrow. Muslim kosher.
Yes.
So I had some extra beef. I threw that in here too. There's coconut cream in here, lychee nuts, pine nuts, bamboo shoots.
Yeah.
So
this is fantastic.
Just about anything will go with that Valencia rice.
So obviously the peas are great because of the vibrant color for your artistry. What else do you use? What will fill some of these other areas?
I'm going to be also using black beans, chopped red pepper, corn. And I'll decorate also with cherry tomatoes and quail eggs.
Fancy.
You can use red cabbage. I like using a bright white hominy for weddings. I'll use that tomorrow.
Beautiful.
So anything that's a natural color.
Got it. So we obviously are showcasing this because this is something that you can do for parties, for catering. You can come and people can see the whole process unfold. You mentioned you're doing a wedding tomorrow. Yeah. How does that work? How can people get in touch with you? And then what's the cost?
My webpage, www.paulspaellas.com, okay. Instagram, Paul's Paellas, TikTok, Paul's Paellas.
Paul's Paellas.
So what, is there anything else out there? I don't know.
I got
my Twitter
Paellas
back too. So
that'll,
just call me up. I'll answer the phone myself. So, and as far as cost, it depends on the size of the pan. The bigger the pan,
got it,
the more expensive, but the less cost per person.
So, okay, that makes sense.
So this is my smallest pan.
Smallest pan.
Ergo, per person is most expensive. This goes for now, unfortunately.
Inflation, we got it. Yeah.
$850
a person, which is
actually $850 for this pan. So this is really my most expensive.
Okay.
But you get more people, you get bigger pans. My 52-incher, I can do a wedding party for 200 people, $995 a person.
Wow.
You can't beat that.
So how many people will a pan this size feed?
This will feed 40 of my portions.
40 of your portions.
Which are big.
I like it, Paul.
Yeah.
All right, we're going to continue following Paul's Paella throughout the morning. Much more fun coming up, including a special musical.
We're in the same business ultimately, huh?
Where do you get your ideas for how you're going to create these?
About 3 or 4 days before I do it. I'm always looking at cooking magazines, molds, and having stuff done. I'm in my garage. During COVID, I'm in my garage with my mold just screwed. I'm not kidding. That's why my designs got so much better after COVID.
Wow.
So I'm always playing around with something.
So these are quail eggs.
Quail eggs, yes. Most people say mozzarella balls the first time they see it.
No?
So,
okay. Yeah.
So just to review, because I thought I heard you say this dish right here would cost $850 for a party and would feed 40 plus.
I would say if it was 40 adults, no other food, they're hungry, 40. Normally 55, 60 possibly.
So that even makes it even more affordable.
So it is. I believe in leftovers. Maltese and Koreans, if there's no leftovers, always wonder, did they eat enough? You know, so I always have extra food.
Well, what a morning, Paul. This is fantastic. Paul. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you.
We've tagged you on a number of posts. Paul's paella. Have you had paella before,
She's
Sedona?
She wanted to get something to eat.
Well,
yes.
I haven't had it before.
Well, you're going to try it then, right?
You are in for a treat.
You like rice?
I do.
Oh, you're going to like this.
All right. Well, Paul, we have this conversation started early in the morning with running with the bulls.
Yeah.
And I just want to bring it right back to that. Will you ever do that again?
No, even if I was 30 years younger, I probably wouldn't do that again. That was interesting. So
a momentary lapse in judgment.
Was, okay. How old were you? You can't just invest in mutual funds. They got to look back at memories too, right?
Oh, okay.
Glad I did it. Been there, done that. Got the handkerchief.
Never do it again. All right.
That's good enough.
So, all right. How is there a typical way to serve up paella?
Get you a plate. I scoop in. You want to try some?
You just scoop? Yes.
Yeah, you got it.
Did you see how I worked that out?
Sedona, you want to try some?
Sure, just a little bit.
Okay.
I'll tell you, let's go. Part of me, the paper plates, but my supply chains, I can't find good plates anymore.
I didn't know if there was a proper etiquette
first
for serving
scoop,
up.
Scoop. Well, and where
do you take the first scoop from? The side?
Anywhere you want. In Spain, you sit around it and you eat in.
Okay.
Little smaller pans.
Got it.
And you're not supposed to bounce around. But I make so much food. You know, a little bit more chicken. Can you do that for me?
Oh, my goodness.
Is that too much?
No, they're not for me. But Sedona, you want.
Well, let's let her take a little bite of yours.
Okay.
Okay. Do we have a little bit here? You like her own? I think she likes her own.
Okay.
She deserves her own.
Okay.
And watch out. These are not good plates, all right? Alrighty, get a little rice in there too, I guess.
And Paul, can you tell people where they can find you?
Get your fork. Oh, you got one fork?
Yeah. Thank you.
www.paulspaellas.com.
Let me hold the microphone for you.
Instagram, Paul's Paellas. TikTok, Paul's Paellas. Just go to Google, type in Paul's Paellas.
And will your phone ring after being here?
I'm surprised it hasn't rang yet. I usually get a lot of business after talking to you guys.
Oh,
well, very cool.
So
well, that's the power of KUSI's audience, man.
Boom.
I hope everyone
got good taste. They got good taste.
Everyone not.
Right.
Okay. That's a cashew right on top of there.
Mm-hmm. Oh my goodness. So good.
Bomba rice, low and slow, put the right ingredients in, and it's idiot proof. All I got to do is avoid burning it, so low temperature, you know? Really, it's now the design takes some work. Customer.
So
you have to wait, okay?
So, but it takes about 2 hours, even for the different size pans? This is
About three, really.
Okay.
This rice likes, Bomba rice absorbs 30% more liquid. It likes to be cooked slowly. Plus, at one point, I'll lower it, I'll almost shut it off, so I can actually decorate. I don't want to burn the rice.
Right.
So, for me, these take a little bit more time. Now, I need a day for shopping, a day for chopping. It's really a three-day thing, which is why this is the smallest pan you can get.
Right.
So, we got a small crowd, hey, nobody complains about leftovers. I bring the tubs, you know, you're all good to go. The KUSI crew is starting to come. It's going to be good.
The KUSI crew and the band that we're going to hear from.
Plenty of food for them, too.
You have met your calling, my friend. This is amazing.
Well done, Paul.
It's a good retirement option, huh?
Thank you.
Are we